We started the strategy of complex generics. So some of the injectables and other complex generics portfolio that we have launched during the last financial year, the full quarter impact of that has come in this quarter. And that's why you have seen, for example, if you have launched azacitidine, we have been able to retain the market share and the price remain there. Desitabine also, so far we are there as a solo generic player. We expect Sandoz to launch very soon. And we have got a good market there. Similarly, Reclast and other Divalprox here. So all the molecules that we have launched in FY14 have done pretty well in FY15. Comparatively, some of the new launches that we have done in FY15 first quarter is yet to pick up. And whatever, you know, the pricing control has happened the last year, this year there has been that inflation-led increase which has been taken. So the net impact will be very insignificant. So we expect India to grow better than the market growth. Market share, even, you know, some other, even for example, a Natarvastatin, we have been improving market share. So in the US, we are doing quite well. Whatever Cymbalta upside was to be taken, it has been taken by the players we have launched during that time, sell guidance. But if you have seen, while we are spending more on R&D, that is basically to fuel growth for the future, we are very conscious of spending R&D in a very productive way. So we are spending more on R&D, we are spending more on CapEx. But if you have really looked at our free cash flow, which has been increasing also, like FY14 was far better than FY13. Even the current quarter, free cash flow is quite good. Despite that, we have spent 11% of sales on R&D and we have spent another 227 crores on CapEx. Breaking even and positive on EBITDA rather than focusing on top line. We have not been participating in the tender business at all. So our whole game plan is not to get into the commoditized part of the business, but keep on, you know, filing products which have a better potential in the future. So that's where we are focusing now. So on the top line, there are erosions which are happening. We are not concerned about that. Anyway, Europe as a percentage of revenue for the overall doctor, it is very insignificant.